Hey, everybody, good night. How y'all doing today? We are getting ready for day two. If you're on live with me, please look above my head. You're going to see a link explaining that StreamYard wants you to give them permission to show your name. It looks like they are not very good friends with Facebook as yet. So they're wanting you to give them permission. So as you come in, click that link and say hello for me. Help me test it out so we can see if it works. I see someone gave a love button, and I'm hoping that I'll see a name pop up if someone can help me test while we're waiting to start. This is our pre-session party, people. Had a little bit of music. Were you able to hear the music? If you are watching this on the replay, we are just testing. We're not starting yet. So you can always fast forward to about 10 minutes in so that you can start watching the lesson. But we're just testing. Colleen, thank you. Colleen from Longville, Georgia. Hi, Colleen. How are you enjoying this so far? Carol, hey, rich friend. Nice to see you. Thank you for spending this time with me. Yes, Colleen heard the music. Maybe we can have a little pre-party every night then, just get ourselves ready. We're talking about conflict resolution, but we want it to be as relaxed and easy as we could and just be vibing, you know? So we're getting ready. What you eating? What you're eating? If you're in the supper club, tell me what you're having for supper while we learn tonight. What are you eating? Aliyah is going to post the supper club thread and the homework thread tonight. She's going to post the supper club thread so that you can post your meal, because we have a prize that is for people in the supper club. If you post your meal every night for the 5 nights that we're doing this, posting your meal enters you to win the supper club superstar prize. And she's also going to post the pick for the homework thread. And posting your homework from tonight gets you entered for the homework hero. Greetings from Trinidad and Tobago. Can you click the link above my head as you come in? It's either here or here, but it's above my head. You're not going to be directed anywhere. Just click that link for me. So say hi. Hey, Luda. Thanks for joining. Where are you joining from? I am going to get some water to sip on, and I'll be right back, and then we can start. I'll be back in 2 minutes. It's not going to take that long to get water, right? Ha Karen, you can get some apple juice. Good night, Carolyn. How are you doing? Thank you for clicking the link. As you come in, please click the link above my head here or here. It's not going to direct you or redirect you anywhere else. It's just going to give Facebook permission to show your name as we chat. Did everyone get a chance to do the homework? How was that? How did that go? Did you get a chance to do homework tonight? Pop in the comments and let me know what you thought about it. Last night's homework or takeaway was to choose a situation and evaluate it based on what we talked about last night. Evaluate it at the definition, see what category it fits into, and make notes and post that in the thread. And it's not too late if you didn't get a chance to do it last night. You can totally catch up tonight. And when you post that, you are in the running for the prize of Homework Hero. If you did get a chance to do your homework, I would love to see in the comments what kind of conflict you identified. Whether you are watching this on the replay or you're watching live, let us know in the comments what kind of conflict you identified. And maybe later on I'll share my homework because I did it too. I have to lead by example, so I did my homework too. But I want to hear yours first. Okay. It's 7 p.m. and we want to be off to a good start. Tonight, we are going to talk about discovering our inner me. Welcome formally. We can't start unless I welcome you. Today is Tuesday, the 4th of August. And we are on day 2 of our conflict resolution workshop series. If you are new to me, my name is Tabitha, and I help professional women who are overwhelmed by workplace conflict lead thriving teams with success and with confidence. I also work with corporate clients. I work with nonprofits. I work with businesses. I'd like to thank you for being here, and I'd also like to thank Aaliyah, who is our intern, for all the help that she's been doing to make everything look so fabulous. If you know me, you will know exactly what Aaliyah has done. You'll know that all the pretty stuff that you see is certainly not my doing. I am creative, but I'm not artistic, and that's one of Aaliyah's strengths, and I'm so grateful that she's here, and I want to thank her for all she's doing for our workshop series. Juliet, thank you. I see that you chose the conflict that you had with your former principal. I hope that this gave you some enlightenment. And as we walk through the week, if you sit with that issue, I hope that you get some light bulb moments. And working in retrospect helps you to move forward so that if another kind of conflict shows up, you have the tools to deal with it. Vidya, good evening. Thank you for stopping by. Nice to see you. Welcome to our series. Here we deal with conflict, but we deal with it in a positive way, in a way that always inspires us to hope, in a way that gives us tools to walk the path of conflict resolution with grace, and to help people as we help ourselves. Good night, Samantha. Good night, Davey. And if you're coming in and you're joining us, please click the link above my head here or here. I'm not sure which side it's on, but that link isn't going to direct you anywhere else. It's just going to let StreamYard show show me who's saying hi so that we can chat. Tonight, we're welcoming friends from the Bahamas, Barbados, Cayman, Guyana, India, Italy, Jamaica, South Africa, St. Kitts and Nevis, Trinidad and Tobago, the United Kingdom, and the United States of America. So this is shout out time. We are an international community in your resolution room, and I want you to flood the comments with me and let me know which country or city you are from. And as you do that, please remember to click the link above so that I can know who's coming and who's saying hi from where. There's a little bit of a delay, so it's going to take a minute to pop up, but me asking you to do this also tells me how fast it's going. So pop in the comments where you're from, and if you're watching this on the replay, please also share so that we can greet you and say hello. I know that our friends in India and in the United Kingdom will be watching tomorrow. Also, our friend in South Africa will probably be watching tomorrow. Vidyahar from Georgetown, Guyana, thank you. Nice for being here. Aaliyah from the Bahamas. Carol from St. Kitts, thanks for joining us. Carol from Lafayette in Indiana. I know that Juliet is here from Dallas. I think we have someone from Trinidad and Tobago, but I'm not too sure whose name it is. Thank you for liking my backdrop. If you could click above my head on that link and see who it is, so that Facebook and StreamYard can tell me who it is, I would appreciate that. We welcomed quite a number of new people to Resolution Room yesterday and today, and I tried in the posts to bring everyone up to speed. And if you are new to the group, please send a message to Aaliyah. Let her know you're new and she'll walk you through what to do. If you're new to the group, also scroll our page. We've been very busy and you're going to see a lot of information that's going to bring you up to speed. So thank you very much for joining. What you're eating, guys. It's time for Supper Club. Post in the thread what you're eating and let me know. Whatever it is, it's going to be better. It's Grace from Dallas. So two Texas in the house, two Texans, Juliet from Katy and Grace from Dallas. Thanks, Grace. Nice to see you. Nice to see you. PSA, please check your email inboxes, the ones that you use to register, and look for the worksheets as they come in. They're going to come out early every morning, and we want you to check your inboxes so that you're sure to get them. Grace, nice. Grace, post a picture of that in the thread, in the Supper Club Superstar thread. We got to see that. If anyone is not from Guyana, there is something called cowfoot soup. If you eat anything like that, or if anything like that is a dish that you have in your country, post that and go over to the Supper Club thread and make sure that you look at Grace's own, because I'm sure it's fabulous. Oh, tonight it's soup. Devine split pea soup, Grace cowfoot soup, and someone is eating whatever. Vidya, thank you for feeding on our lesson tonight. You're a good student. Vidya gets the prize. No eating in class. I'm very, very glad that you're here tonight. Thanks for spending some time with me as we set up. And always feel free to go and review what you've done last night to bring yourself back up to speed. And our new people, just touch base with Aaliyah and she'll help you get oriented. Before you do, there's a lot of information on our feed, so just scroll through and take a look at it. All right, We are getting ready to begin. And as we start, let us be fully present in the moment. There's a reason that you're here. Whether you were invited by a friend, you came across our post on social media, or we knew each other from before, there's a reason that you came into your room tonight, and there's a reason that we're going through the Conflict Resolution Workshop series together. And whatever reason that is for you, just sit with it for a minute and be fully present in the moment. In this room and in this series, we are going to learn new things and unlearn old things. And the invitation is to be still while we do it. We start our session again tonight with our affirmations. And this will be our workshop affirmation. I am open to miracles by Josie Ong. And as we read this affirmation, the invitation is for you to be still. Close your eyes if you're comfortable with that. Whatever you need to do to be still and be present in the moment and to center yourself, we do that. I am open to miracles by Josie Ong. I am open to miracles in my life. I am open to love. I am open to transformation. I am open to the best year of my life. I am harvesting health, peace, and joy. I feel lucky. I feel fortunate. I feel blessed. I ease into serendipitous flow. I deserve happiness. I am worth the goodness that is overflowing in my life. I receive health, wealth, and all my dreams coming through. I receive abundance. I am living my dream. I'm receiving fulfillment I never had. I'm receiving inner peace, contentment, and joy that I never experienced before. I am comfortable receiving all of this because I am shedding old beliefs. I am shedding old behaviors. I'm shedding old relationships. I am in a new skin. I am stepping into the life that I am made for. I am ready to receive the miracles awaiting me. I am ready for smile after smile. I am immersed in life's love. I am basking in lasting happiness. I welcome the miracles. I welcome the miracles. I welcome the miracles as today I discover my inner me. Yesterday we talked about conflict. We defined it. We looked at conflict is a struggle between two or more entities over values and over competition for status, power, or scarce resources. And we spent some time in reflection and we identified a conflict that we were involved in the past or are currently involved in. And we found a place to put it. And so many of you posted the homework thread. Thank you. I was able to review those and I was able to see that you are indeed using this definition to deconstruct the things that you've experienced so that you understand going forward what is conflict and what is not conflict, where we ask people to use their own resources to work things out without stepping in, understanding that there is something called good conflict. Not every conflict is something that is bad. And today we are going to talk about our inner me. As we do that, let us hold the conflict that we have identified because that is what we're going to work with during the week. And we're going to do a little bit more getting to the root cause of the conflict. And how do we do that? First, we look inward. There is a lot that can be said about behavior and conflict and behavior in conflict. And there's a lot about conflict that depends on our reaction to it. And always the best course of reaction when we are confronted with conflict is to first look inward. And why am I saying that we're looking inward? Because sometimes our inner me can be our biggest enemy. And so we want to tackle that first. We want to tackle our enemy and make sure that it's not an enemy so that we can step into the arena with all of our faculties, grounded in our truths, grounded in what we know, and also having our tools, having these worksheets that you're going to keep. And so we have to be careful first to check our inner me and see what's happening there. So we look inward first, and when we understand that conflict is three-dimensional. There is first the cognitive aspect of conflict, and it's the cognitive or perception aspect of it. And let us stay right here with us. We're not right now looking at the other party to the conflict. Let us stay right where we're right here where we are. And when we're in conflict, what I think is important. What I think is that deep-seated belief that our needs, interests, and values are incompatible with the other person. So we want to do that check first, the cognitive check. What am I thinking? What do I need? What am I thinking about this conflict? Am I applying my needs? And if I'm doing that, am I applying my needs to the exclusion of other needs? Am I doing the same thing with interests? Am I first looking for my interests to the exclusion of others? Or am I trying to look at both? Or am I looking at the other side's interests without paying attention to my own? What are my values? Are these values that were taught to me? And if so, did I test those values against what I know to be true? Or am I just keeping those values and taking them through situations without really understanding where they apply, where they might collide with someone else's values, and trying to figure out how I can not change my values, but be cognizant of someone else's own when we sit at the table together and honor theirs in the same way that I would hope they would honor mine. So the first dimension of conflict that our enemy wants to be mindful of is the cognitive dimension. The second dimension is the emotional dimension, and that deals with what we're feeling. So what I feel is that second dimension. And conflict can be generated by emotional reactions to a situation, often to the point where people are no longer rational. And so we find here that the emotional reaction taking place inside of one person, or sometimes two people feeding off the other, makes the conflict bigger than it was. And this is where I am going to segue into something that Adonola mentioned last night. She talked about conflict. She asked a question last night in the thread that brought me up to talk about intrapersonal conflict. So without getting too technical, there's conflict that happens here. And what's that conflict? I didn't sleep so well last night. I got up this morning and I got some calls that I didn't expect. And my husband and I are doing a really important transaction. We had a lot of calls today. We had to sign some documents by email and I had deadlines. I couldn't meet with Aaliyah and I was worrying, does she have stuff? Is she waiting on me for stuff? And then we had new people to admit to your resolution room. And then I thought, gosh, I'm getting some emails and some DMs. I don't think people got their email. So I need to go into the software that we use to send you email and I have to check to see if they're there. Then I've got to make sure that they get their worksheets. And then, oh my goodness, it's lunchtime and I didn't get to prepare anything. Ah, right, they're the crackers. Let me have some crackers and I better give my husband too because there's nothing going on for lunch today. So here's some crackers, honey. I have some, you have some. And I continue to work. And then, oh my goodness, there was a check that needed to go out and the bank is closed. So let's get the checkbook and do something personal. Does that sound familiar? That is all happening in here. It sounds like intrapersonal conflict. And some of that conflict I can deal with. Sometimes it gets above the normal stresses of life. When it does, we use resources. We use our own resources, the way we speak to ourselves, the things we say, the messages we transmit to ourselves, or we use outside resources. We text a friend. We call a friend. We listen to something inspirational, whether it is religious or something that's just mindfulness, and we do self-care. And a lot of our intrapersonal conflict can be taken care of if we use our own resources so that I can do that and show up to hang with you tonight and be present. So that's the internal conflict or the intrapersonal conflict that we experience. And then sometimes it is still intrapersonal conflict, but it's caused by an outside force. And then we have to govern the way we react to that outside force. And we have to govern what we do, what we permit, what we let into our space. And we have to govern the way we set boundaries. And there's a wonderful book on boundaries by, it's Henry Cloud and Robert Townsend. And if you have issues with someone encroaching on you in a way that doesn't allow you to care for yourself or advocate for yourself, then that's a goodbye and a good book for you to take a look of. Thank you, Carol. Yes, positive self-talk, deep breathings. Therapy is your friend. Therapy is everyone's friend, whether we like to admit it or not. Self-governance is critical. I see the person is listed as a Facebook user, and if you could click up here or up here so that Facebook can show your name, I am betting that that might be Dr. Ian Levine. And Dr. Ian Levine is extremely well-versed in positive self-talk. And he and I are talking about scheduling and a live interview here so that he can talk a little bit more about positive self-talk and just give us more resources to care for ourselves and to govern ourselves, whether or not we are. Carol, yes, that is the book. Thank you so much. Thank you. Appreciate it. Everyone, Carol is our best friend tonight. She has put the link for the book, Boundaries. I'm going to take a look at it once we're off, and I'll confirm. But it's a really, really good book on boundaries by Cloud and Townsend. It helped me, and I'm quite sure it could help you too. So we've looked at conflict, and we've looked at the fact that it's three-dimensional, the cognitive dimension, the emotional dimension. Both of those dimensions can affect the way we show up in conflict or even by ourselves. And the third dimension is the action dimension. What I do, how do I behave? There are many ways that active displays of conflict behavior can deliberately affect the needs of the other person. The way you gesture, what does that say? If I do that, it says, I really don't have much time for you. Or if you and I are in conversation and you're standing here and I'm standing here and then all of a sudden you see me relating to you like this, looking over somewhere else, or you see me doing something like this, and then it sends a message. What message does it send? I'm not fully present, I'm not engaged, and I am not giving you the attention that you need and deserve for us to work out whatever it is that is on the table for us to do. So those are three dimensions of conflict that I'd like you to sit down and think about. When you look at the conflict that you identified, you can ask yourself in that moment some questions, and you can reflect on these three dimensions and see how you showed up and how it affected the way you showed up in the conflict that you identified. Because if I believe that you are trying to hurt me, I will feel as though I'm in conflict with you, and then I am likely to engage in conflict behaviors. If I believe that you are trying to hurt me, I will feel as though I'm in conflict with you, and then I'm likely to engage in conflict behaviors. So those are the prompts on your worksheet to complete and fill in. And that's a resource that I would like you to keep and use as you talk to people or as you yourself approach conflict. I would love for you to keep that resource and take a look at it from time to time as you go through your reflections. So it's all about the three dimensions of conflict: cognitive, emotional, and behavioral. And so one of the things that I like to do to get oriented about what is happening, and a good thing that you can practice, is to learn how to take a 360 degree view. And when we take a 360 degree view, we collect and look at all the significant information available so that we can make the best decision on what to do. If there's anyone who's writing, I'll say it again. When we take a 360 degree view, we collect and look at all the significant information available so that we can make the best decision on what to do. A 360 degree view will help you with introspection. It'll help you with your inner work, and it'll help to support you and to support your approach managing the conflict that you select for this challenge. And whether it's your first time being involved in an exercise like this, or if you've done it before, conflict dynamics are always evolving. Issues always pop up in different ways and in different places. And so understanding your enemy and taking a 360 degree view are things that we should do regularly. So what we want to do is get to a place where we're doing this almost every issue, with almost every issue that we're looking at. We're taking a 360 view and we're doing that. What does a 360 view look like? Let's say, for example, let's use a workplace conflict scenario. I'm in an office We're working on a project. I am not the leader of the project, but I am the best technical person. And I'm wondering how to get across that things are not going well, that there's a need for training, and that there's a need for you to upgrade skills. The first thing that I do if I'm taking a 360 view is I look at everyone else in the room. And I go back to my definition of conflict. The first thing I do is identify, what is this about? Values, status, power, scarce resources. It might be resources. It might be that because they're not upskilled, they are not strong enough resources for the project. And it could be that they are not upskilled because resources were not available. So I need to think that through and deconstruct that and start making some notes. And so I'm taking a 360 view and I'm looking at everyone in the room and I'm looking at my supervisor and I'm looking at the things that my supervisor has to be concerned about. And then I am also understanding that there are things that I may not know. My supervisor may be concerned about things that I don't know. And then I'm looking at the other people who are on the project and I'm asking myself, what are they doing? What are they thinking? What are they feeling? Do they want to be here? Do they have the skills? And if they have the skills, is it that they're just scared of coming up and showing up and doing the work? And then I can talk to them. And I can ask them those questions without it sounding as though I'm doing an interview. And by the time I gather enough information, it will do two things. A, tell me whether I should approach and whether I should say something. And if the answer to that is yes, the second thing that that 360 degree view will do is tell me what to say when I approach. Because having done that, I have looked at the needs and interests of everyone in the room. And so when I speak to them, I'm speaking from a place of wanting to collaborate, wanting to be transparent, wanting to be respectful, and acknowledging all of those needs, all of those values, all of those interests in collaborating to get that project completed. So that approach, the 360 degree approach, is something that I like to invite each of you to do when you look at the conflict you identified yesterday. The second tip that we're going to talk about today that will help us to govern our enemy and to teach our enemy and to inform our enemy is going to the balcony. Yes, Avanese, the 360 degree approach. It tells you if you should act, how you should act, what you should say. Going to the balcony. Going to the balcony is a great way of taking that 360 degree view of the conflict you're working on. That tip, going to the balcony, is tip number 7 in the ebook that I wrote, The 31 Strategies, Effective Conflict Resolution. And you received that ebook in your day 1 email as a download. So that comes as a part of the package with 31 strategies. So once our workshop series is completed, if you are interested, we can continue doing little tips using that and working on conflict resolution right in our room. So for today, we're looking at going to the balcony, and that's tip number 7. Going to the balcony means that you're putting emotional distance between yourself and the person or the situation. You're thinking about yourself as an outside observer and taking a top-down view of the interest. And in doing that, you're staying on the balcony. A top-down view of the incident, sorry. And staying on the balcony helps you keep a clear head in conflict and you're less likely to be reactive. And this tip is something that you can use anywhere. It's like you can take it anywhere with you. Think of yourself as a drone. Let me think of an example. We just moved from Tennessee to Michigan, and we're buying a home. And when we buy a home, we are going to send someone to inspect the home. And that person is going to be qualified, and they're going to be licensed by the state, and they're going to be experienced in doing home inspections. But there is one part of that home that is very important to us that they're going to have to see, and that's the roof. And so what are they going to do? They're going to get themselves a drone, send that drone up, and take pictures of the roof. If they see anything, they're going to send someone up to check it, and then they're going to inform us. If you think about it, the home inspector is a professional. They've done this for many years. They're licensed in the state, and they know what they're doing, but they still need to get high up to look down to be able to see everything. And so this is what it looks like if you are going to go to the balcony. There is a tool that's called detachment that is really, really helpful. And that's the first thing you're going to do. You're going to detach yourself emotionally from the issue and the outcome. And then you are going to step high up above the fray. And you are going to pretend that you are the director in a movie. And you are going to look at everything. And you're going to, again, use our definition for conflict. What is this person doing? What is the other person doing? And you're going to identify what's happening where. And if you do that, you might see that the different players in the different situations in that room or in that conflict setting have different agendas. Going to the balcony helps you to understand and take a top-down view, detached both emotionally and from outcomes, and to see how best things are working in a situation. So that is a tip that I would love you to do. Samantha asks, what if the person does not allow you to go on the balcony? Samantha, that is going to the balcony is in your is totally in your control. No one can prevent you from doing something that happens internally. If someone is doing that, then you give them too much power, or you don't have the kind of boundaries that you need to have so that you can take care of yourself. And if there are red flags there, then you have to take a good look at the situation. And I would recommend the book Boundaries by Cloud and Townsend, because it teaches you aspects of self-care and setting boundaries. Vidya, detached from the outcome. Vidya asked a question here. What do I mean detached from the outcome? And I'll say it like this. Sometimes you want something so bad that it colors your judgment. It colors the way you react. And it colors the way that you behave in a situation. But if you think about negotiating for something, and you're pulling up at a table to negotiate with someone, you don't let them know how much you want it, because you want to be able to negotiate for yourself the best outcome. And so sometimes you hold closely to your chest the value of what something is to you, so that you can negotiate without being emotionally involved in the situation. So that is what I mean, detaching yourself from the outcome. And that is a negotiation tip that I teach in my group program, and it's called BATNA, our best alternative to the negotiated agreement, and it's working out your BATNA. When you do that, you give yourself the peace of knowing, if I don't get this outcome, this is what I'm going to get. And you have plan A or plan B. You sit with those two plans and you detach yourself and you say, I am going into this. I know these are the things that can happen. I don't know which one is going to happen, but I am going to go into this situation and give it my best effort. So that's what I meant video when I said being detached from the outcome. Thanks so much for asking. I hope that helps. Someone said know when to walk away. Yes, that is one of the famous songs that I love from Kenny Rogers. And sometimes I sing it when I'm about to walk away from a situation. You have to know when to walk away from a negotiation or from a situation. And you have to know at what point in time what is best for you. And someone else says, Eleanor Roosevelt said that no one can make us unhappy without our permission. We are in control of us. Yes, indeed, we are. We are in control, and our heavenly being is also in control. The other tip that I want to mention is number 25 from the same resource, the ebook, and it's Hear Their Perspective. And while you're thinking about the conflict, try spending some time finding out what the other person thinks about the situation. And I wanted to share what I think is a wonderful example of this. If you like movies, there is a movie recommendation that I would love for us in the resolution room to watch and maybe talk about one day, do a session on it. The name of the movie, if you have your pens, is The Best of Enemies. The Best of Enemies. And it stars Sam Rockwell and Taraji P. Henson. Sam Rockwell played the character of C.P. Ellis, who was a KKK leader. And Taraji Henson played Anne Atwater, who was an activist, a political and social activist. It was a wonderful movie. It is a wonderful movie. I was able to watch it. And a very small synopsis. There were problems in a particular area, and it was a tension and conflict based on race. And so it was a conflict of status, of power, of values, and it also led to scarce resources. It was in the days of segregation. It was in the days of racial tension. Some may say, and I would agree, that those days are still here, but it was in those days that movie was set. And they called someone in to hold a session called a charrette. Charrette. And he came in to hold a charrette, which is sort of a fact-finding mission or a conversation, a series of conversations. And he invited all parties to the room. And so black and white, regardless of what you felt, regardless of what you believed, you were invited into the room. And, you know, there was the usual discomfort about sitting together, about eating together, very well explained in the movie. And it's one that I recommend you watch. But what I wanted to quote from the movie is a line that Anne Atwater used to some teenagers. One of the black ministers, preachers, asked permission at the end of the charrette to sing a hymn at the end of the meeting. And C.P. Ellis stood up and said, if you want to sing about God, then I need to be able to display my KKK regalia. And so the person who was holding the charrette said, that is fair, go ahead and do that. And so there was some tension around that. And some young teenage boys were actually putting themselves in a position of going to destroy the regalia that was outside on display every night. You had to walk past that. Symbols of hate, symbols of anger, symbols of violence against Blacks. And everyone had to walk past that going into the meeting. And Anne Atwater's character stopped the teenagers, stopped them from destroying it. And she said to them, if you want to understand how to deal with the KKK, you need to first understand who they are and what they believe and what they do. And that was a very, very powerful line from that movie, where she actually invited the younger generation to stop an act of violence and first understand your enemy, or understand the person who is in the position of your enemy. And so I wanted to share that with you as an example of how powerful it is to hear their perspective. At the end of, by the end of the movie, and this is a true story that was made into a movie, by the end of the movie, they were successful in getting access to education, equal access to education in the town. They were successful in meeting their goals, school and housing conditions. They were successful in desegregating the schools. And Anne Atwater and C.P. Ellis became lifelong friends. They traveled the United States of America, both speaking on the same platform and promoting unity and speaking against racism. And they remained lifelong friends. Anne Atwater spoke and gave the eulogy at C.P. Ellis's funeral. Understanding someone's perspective is sometimes more powerful than we could think if we just lean into that and we take some time to spend doing that. Knowing how that person views the issue can help you understand what motivates them, and it can give you a roadmap towards resolution. Probe as much as you can until they tell you what's motivating their position. And when I say probe, I mean do it gracefully. I am from the Caribbean, and there's some times that we probe and it's not necessarily kind. There's some things that we can say that are not necessarily kind. Be respectful. Even if you don't understand why someone is taking a position, just asking them why. Your tone, the way you speak, and the way you project an interest and a genuine caring is very important in finding perspective. Thank you, Dr. Levine. Each one's perspectives are based on their inner programming, based on their experience, etc. Yes. And if we don't understand that inner programming and we don't ask about it, then we hardly ever see what it is. We must first understand. Always think first to understand. There's someone who says, "Blessed evening to all. Since the conflict could be with family members, it may be useful to consider speaking about the opposing party." Well, yes, but if it is family members, you just, that word opposing itself can be such a trigger. And sometimes you just want to say other, as in having another belief, having another value, other beliefs, other values. And we take the sting out of opposition. Using the word opposing invites just that sometimes, opposition into the space. And we could say another view, another party, another family member, another team member. And so we can just express it that way. You know, if it's a family member, you can say, "I know you have another view. Or do you have another view that you'd like to share with me? I want to be respectful about everything that you say, and we want to be respectful of all views." And Carol gives us a tidbit. Her people are from Sierra Leone. Yes. I'm from the Caribbean, and I think we all came from the same place. Yes. Yes. So hear their perspective. Thank you for that quote. The best way to destroy an enemy is to make him a friend. Yes, indeed. It's one of the very useful ways to destroy an enemy, because when they become your friend, then they can't be your enemy anymore. So for our activity, you know, I don't like to leave you without something fun to do at home. So we've got today's activity, Try Me. But before we do that, do we have any questions or comments? If anyone wants me to ask anything, please go ahead and ask me in the comments and I'll answer. Someone says, author is fine. Yes. So if anyone has any questions, ask away. Otherwise, I'm going to pop in the comments later and continue asking. Your activity, your Try Me activity, is your homework. And for today, it's reflectional journaling. And you've got some extra paper at the back of your worksheets. We're a one-stop shop. We want to provide for you and keep you comfortable and keep you centralized so that you can put these into a binder at the end of our workshop series and be able to work on stuff. For our homework activity, we're going to be led through a journaling exercise, and we are going to look at our inner me, and we're going to do that with respect to the conflict that we identified last night. So we're going to sit with that conflict we identified last night, and then we are going to ask ourselves, what do I feel about the conflict? What did I do about the conflict? What do I think about the conflict? And we're going to write those answers, and we're going to think deeply about them. If I can take a moment, I don't see any questions, so maybe I can share my homework. My homework last night, the conflict that I identified is the Black Lives Matter movement. And for me, it hit so many parts of the definition. It is a struggle, and it is between two or more entities. And for me, it hit values, because to me, in my perspective, clearly there are different groups holding different values about how Black people are treated and how white people are treated. And so it hit there for me. Also, status, for the same reason, because the ground is not always level where race is concerned, and power, because again, for many reasons, different races have different resources, have access to different rooms, and therefore have the power that goes along with the access that they have to different rooms. And so that was my homework. I identified that movement as the conflict that I wanted to look at. And then from my Try Me, I did a little bit of thinking and journaling through that. And so I'm going to do that again with the Black Lives Matter movement tonight. For example, if I ask myself, what do I think about the conflict? I think it will improve, but only if there is legislation around it, only if there's conscious activism, only if there's social change. I think that even though it will improve, there are always going to be some aspects that are going to be left in society, and they may always be here because human nature is what it is. And so I'm going to go into reflection on that tonight as I do my homework. So I invite you to do the same with the conflict that you've identified. I invite you to ask any questions under the homework thread. share any takeaways that you may have under the homework thread, and also share a snapshot of your homework so that you can be in the pool, or write out what your homework is so that you can be in the drawing for our Homework Hero Prize. So look for that post in the group. Aliyah is going to post it there. Look for your takeaways, share your light bulb moments, share your homework, and enjoy your evening. I want to be respectful of your time. Our hour has been completed. Thank you so much for investing your time with me. I appreciate this more than you know. Thank you for journeying with me. Thank you for being willing to look at life through a different perspective, look at conflict through a different perspective. And thank you for enjoying the series as you are. Feel free to go ahead and post in the thread and stay active in the group. And there is a post this afternoon where I said, if you don't know someone in the group, tag them. So one of the things we want to do is make a collaborative and friendly society and have our own little family in the resolution room. So go onto that post and tag someone that you don't know and say hello to them. Get to know each other. So your task for today is to not only do your homework, but tag someone either in a new post or under that thread and say hello. Thank you very much. Good night. Blessings to you. And I'll see you tomorrow night. Same time, same place. Love y'all. From my heart to yours. Bye.